Welcome back to another episode of Drag to Amerikkka. I'm your host, Ty Worldwide. Is it possible this Black National Anthem controversy is dividing the world of sports? What's the big deal? Why are many people furious with sports for the songs they choose to play? Let's get straight to it. Lift Every Voice, the Black National song, was written by a great scholar. He came from a humble beginning. He pursued a path in education. He felt educating Black youth was vital for Black lives. Johnson returned to Jacksonville after graduating from a historically Black college in 1894. He began teaching at the Standing Primary School for Black pupils. He was then appointed as the school's principal. Johnson possessed a variety of skills. The Black National Anthem began as a song written for President Abraham Lincoln. Lift Every Voice and Sing was written by James Weldon Johnson in 1900. The song was written by Mr. Weldon, a civil rights leader, as a poem, which his brother adapted to music. Jacksonville, Florida, native James Weldon Johnson was a Black Republican who made the most of his opportunities. According to Johnson, the song was written in response to a request from the community to organize a party to mark Abraham Lincoln's birthday. Many people of color were influenced by the song. The song's lyrics were so important to Black people that the NAACP made it their song for their organization. Some argue that, in light of today's racial tensions, Black people required their own song to be performed at sporting events. The NFL and NBA both have a large number of Black athletes, so it seems appropriate, right? Apparently, some argue that the original national anthem is primarily for white people. Is that correct? I mean, for so many years, the original anthem played in many arenas and events which all people would honor. Why the switch? Was it Colin Kaepernick's fault? Do some feel it's wrong for numerous Black paid athletes to point the finger at a racist society? Are many people outraged to see several professional Black athletes who scream racism get paid by prominent white males? Will there be outrage if whites or other races take a knee during the Black National Anthem at sporting events? Is it true that some Black people claim there's disparity but actually prefer segregation? Or did all of this stem from various racial injustices today that society perpetrates on Black people? As you know, I'm learning and researching trying to understand why everyone's always angry. There are many questions with not a lot of answers. Some argue that because Black people don't have a nation, they don't need an anthem. Why don't Black people have their own society? While learning about 40 acres and a mule, I discovered that Blacks were yearning, actually desiring to separate from whites during slave times. People of color desired to create their own society. At the time, Black people aspired to make the most of their newfound freedom. Unfortunately, the evil slave lords of the Democratic Party didn't want that. They wanted Blacks to be ostracized and kept under lock and key, which made no sense. They despised Black people. It's stunning to know they hated Blacks, yet didn't want them to leave their side. Many Americans associate the Star Spangled Banner with hope. The flag and that hymn are loved by military men, women, and others of all shades of color. When the late, great Whitney Houston sung this song, it was an honor. But is it still an honor when Black people sing it? What about those who don't feel a part of the flag? When Kaepernick took a knee, he did it for all the derogatory treatments he seen towards Blacks. Once he did that, it created a narrative which many thought numerous athletes were ungrateful. Maybe he wanted to use his platform to protest what he felt. Doesn't he have that right in the land of the free? When I hear some media say these rich millionaire players aren't in tune with the issues in Black communities, we all know many Black successful athletes come from less fortunate beginnings. However, I think people shouldn't condemn these individuals. Many Black athletes give back to charity in their own way. My mother tells me often, stagnation is a disease. Many people claim that those Black athletes are so wealthy that they don't understand what it's like to struggle in the hood. Yet I know for sure they have a memory. Some may not want to think about the flashbacks of being poor. Being humble is the key. Yet to those folks stating these athletes don't understand the struggle, I respond to you. You probably never lived in a poor community. It's one thing to tour hard-hit areas. It's another to live there every day. It would be a disservice to the hard effort these Black athletes put in only to stay in areas that may have caused them the most grief in their lives. I believe they put in a lot of effort and were successful in their own endeavors. Everyone in America's hoods can't be LeBron James, but they can still positively succeed. In some hoods, you may see Roach Olympic games outside your door, or professional liquor store beggars on every corner. These beggars don't want a dollar anymore. These beggars want 5 and 10 bucks now that we're in a pandemic. you might see dudes playing a PlayStation 5 outside on the project bench. It's sad this may be the children's leadership in that area. No one talks about that, though. Shouldn't blacks and others in impoverished communities strive to get out and make their own way? Now I ask, what person that made it out the hood, plus reaches a certain cash level, would go live in a poor hood? Do you think LeBron worked hard just to park his Bentley in front of the pawn shop liquor store? My mother didn't even like to park her Grand Am in front of the buildings and the PJs. God's the only one that can judge anyone. My mother always tells me riches will enhance the true person. If these people were selfish broke, they'll be selfish rich. Bottom line. Are other ethnicities gonna want to hear their song played at the game? Jealousy does linger. Should the anthem be rewrote to cater to everyone's desires? It's all confusing. Is this all about politics? If you're a true sports fan, the song really doesn't matter. Some say sports is a place where race, status, or class shouldn't matter. People just want to see their team win. Watching old footage of the turmoil that happened on 9/11 is terrible. However, hearing stories of triumph and learning about that event from my mother, I learned Americans came together on 9/12. Color wasn't important. People treated each other with dignity and love. I wonder how we got here now. With this country's imperfect history, some of this seems hypocritical. Through the grace of God, blacks have prevailed and broke records. Lift Every Voice is more of a prayer and reflection of the black experience. In my opinion, black people can't be surprised everyone won't understand the meaning behind the song. The song really provides hope to any person of any shade. Sadly, many don't see it that way. Some black people didn't hear the song until 2021. Why can't both songs be viewed as pro-American? Is it a white thing, a black thing, or an all-American thing? There's so much division these days. Is unity considered having one anthem for whites and one for blacks? Is this real unity? Time will tell. Tune in to the next episode of Drag to Amerikkka. Make sure to wash your hands a million times and spray Lysol everywhere. I'm Ty Worldwide. Take care. God bless.
America, I just checked my following. Listen, you motherfuckers owe me.